Chris. A-Hole Productions. He does, doesn't he? Holy shit, he does. They said, Eat Feet says, you remind him of Rude Jude. Do you know who Rude Jude is?
No.
Oh my God. You gotta look up this guy, Rude Jude, man. He's on this podcast that I frequent on called Mad Scientist Party Hour. And he's like this, he's this awesome dude. He kind of travels around. He basically, I think he's tried every drug imaginable. he's a white guy, but he doesn't sound white at all. And it's just, and it, he's got this deep kind of voice, but he kind of has a little bit of like your accent a little bit. And he said in the last episode he was on Mad Scientist, he said he doesn't even do like regular drugs anymore, like weed or anything like that, like nothing with a name. He said every drug he's tried in the past 2 years has had like a math equation on it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's hardcore. And he wrote a book about his life, and it's like a top seller. I'm blanking on the name of it. What, Eat Feet, do you remind me the name of his book? Is it Jackal, or it's like a single word, I think, but it's such a great book. Hey, this guy's had a fucking crazy life.
You know, y'all got so many things that I need to look up. I need to like take out a notepad and pen or something, because I got like 800,000 things I should be looking up. And this dude like really torching this area.
Yeah. Future flame trooper there. That's right. Eat Feet says Rude Jude is from Chicago also, and his book is named Hyena.
Wow. I'm going to have to check that out now.
you can get it for like $6 or $8 on Amazon. It's FUD. Such a dude's had a crazy life, man. That's all. Eat Feet, thanks for that reminder, man. Rude Jude is awesome.
Is that an invisible snake? I really don't remember that. Oh, it was. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Did you turn Infinite Ammo on?
No, I didn't. Oh man,
I just wasted my money then.
Well, if you got the little class like already set up, you could just hit like they don't call it select on here. What is it called? I don't know what this button is called. Yeah, whatever you in right there. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if you got multiple classes set up though.
Let's see, display another, change the game settings. Nah, doesn't look like it. That's all right. That's okay.
I went under equip skills.
Yeah, it's... What? Oh, you know what? Equip skills, that's right. I'm sorry, I did see that. I didn't think that would be where it was. Equip skills.
Or is it not letting you steal?
Yeah, it won't let me.
Well, we should be able to make it through this.
Yeah, we're good. We're good. Yeah. I was just trying to make the game easier on us, because I figure if we get in a bad area... To save your ammo, you could hang out behind me. I could just unload the shotgun at things. It's cool. Man, we still got 12 people up in here. Everyone, hey, how's it going? If you're new here, my name is Seek and Destroy, and I'm playing with Lil C32 tonight, who is another great streamer on here on Twitch, an awesome dude. And we're playing the Resident Evil 6 Chris Redfield Pierce Niven's campaign. And we're about to fucking ride some little playground shit over here.
This is so silly right here. I don't understand. Look how he looking.
I know. And it just looks weird. Why is the bear's head aimed at your crotch? Like it looks
backwards.
Like, yeah, like you're. It's like you're riding the bear. It's.
This is crazy.
It's so weird. All right, let's see. I think it's this one or this. Yeah, here we go.
Nah, I never knew you could do that. That was kind of cool right there. I never knew you can go up the slide, though, in all the times I played this.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
That's hilarious. Yeah, because, see...
Okay, his is different.
Yeah, he's got a different one. But Pierce doesn't. I don't think he rides it. Yeah, see, he just jumps over the panda. Oh no, yeah, no, it's cool. Eat Feet. We know. Eat Feet says if you look up Rude Jude and you end up not liking the guy, he didn't mean any disrespect. It's like no,
I don't take it. Nah. I'm not that type of person. I don't take it offensive.
Yeah. No, I figured you wouldn't. All right. Let's get it on. Get it on the floor. Get it on the floor. Dude, orange soda may have been invented by God.
It's that good over there.
Oh my goodness. Like, normally I take sips of soda, but that was like a big gulp. I'm like, so good. The only thing about this game, too, is that they go ahead.
It's an emblem right here.
That's what I was looking for. I was like, I know there's one over here. Thank you for that. Because they put, as we get closer to the end of the game, they put emblems in weird places from here on out. Oh, there's an herb over here if you need a green herb.
All right.
All right. Orange soda equals proof of higher power, Eat Feet says. To me, it does. To me, it does. I love these environments, though. I like, they're very claustrophobic. It's a neat idea to go to China for the construction, you know, like the architecture design, because everything's just like built on top of each other. And I feel like that's very Resident Evil, you know, like the tight spaces, tight hallways. Oh, that's a shadow. Shit. I'm like, where is he? Oh, he's behind us. See, there's shit. See them? Are those our shadows? See. These are our shadows. How the hell is that possible?
Oh, yeah, it is.
How is that possible?
And why is it so far? That means it would have to be a light behind us.
We would have to be standing on lights.
But this one is...
Yeah.
This ain't possible. Oh, they got the real world physics right there. Great shadow in there. That's crazy. Yeah,
that was terrible.
Good old Resident Evil.
Oh, shit.
Wait a minute. Oh, wow. Hold up.
Out. Oh shit. Ariel's laughing at our shadow dance. Don't lose your head.
They disintegrate like the monsters off Blade 1 and 2.
I know, yeah, like the vampires. I was mentioning that too. There's something built in, I guess, for them. It's weird because you would think like Carla and all the people behind the development of the C-virus, they want it to spread, yet the reason I think one of the files says they disintegrate is because they're like, oh, this will leave no evidence behind, so our enemies can't get a sample of the C-virus and duplicate it for themselves. And I'm like, so you want the virus to spread, but you want to leave no trace of the virus? Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Good old Resident Evil logic. And once again.
Yeah.
Oh, Chris got the neck crack on here still.
Dang, nice.
And a straight punch. I'm starting to like Chris.
Is he growing on you now?
Yeah, I'm starting to like this guy because I really didn't like playing as him when I used to play through the campaigns.
Gotcha. Yeah.
Is this door faded out for you?
Did it fade away?
No, is it like faded?
Oh,
like
yes.
More than normal. It's like faded more than a normal door would be. I guess so.
And the handle doesn't look three-dimensional on it. It's like a flat texture.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. It didn't look right.
Eat Feet says this story. The game, the story of this game has more holes than Swiss cheese.
Wow. The Swiss cheese.
That's awesome. They're alive. They went missing 6 months ago in Adonia.
Oh, then got Chris mad.
Yeah.
Captain Marco, that's an armored chopper they brought in.
It rules out conventional arms.
We need to protect them around this. Forget the chopper for now. Engage the Tuavo.
Oh, okay. I'm like shooting at the chopper.
Well, I sure was shooting at the chopper.
Got one. Oh, this is where they become like
grasshoppers or something.
Yeah, they do.
It's some weird grasshopper. That's the only thing I remember about this. There they go right there.
Oh, shit. Out of here.
What should we do?
Yo, hey, what's up, FGI, man? How's it going, dude? How you been? Dude, it's been a while. How are you? Oh, shit. Missed. Everybody, shout out to FGI, dude. Super nice guy in here. Oh, damn.
What up, FGI?
Nice. Lil C says hey, too, man.
Yeah.
Do you know him? Does he follow you by any chance? Ever seen?
No, that's the first time I heard that one, but it's okay. All good still.
He's a cool dude, man. He was streaming. His friend, like her dog, had like got hit, or a cat, got named Kaiju, I believe it was. Correct me if I'm wrong, FGI. This is a while ago, but it was like her cat was hit by a car, and so so they did like a crowdfunding thing to help the cat. And so I had $5. I had like $15 in my account. I was like, well, I'll give $5. You know, that's what I can do for right now. And then I made like a YouTube video about it. And he was literally playing games like for a couple days, raising money, and he was matching every donation he got, which was just super. I love seeing people do stuff like that. He's a super nice guy.
Mm-hmm.
Come get some. You feel like having grasshopper sandwich? Oh, there's crates over here.
Okay.
Eat Feet says, hey, FGI. What have you been streaming lately, FGI? I don't know what games you've been playing lately. I haven't seen you on. I get auto-hosted by you a lot, which is super nice of you. I haven't seen you physically on because I'm like, I got to pop in on that guy's streams. And I'm probably because I'm streaming at the same time as you or I'm like at work when I, you know. Oh, here we go.
How do we even get down there?
Oh, we don't. I think we stay up here the whole time.
Oh, okay.
So now, there we go. So now, we have to kill like a certain amount of them. There we go. Don't run.
I'm the last one.
Get him. Dang it. Thank you. Thanks for being a better shot than me. I was like, I missed with like three sniper rifles.
Oh, that's all cool.
Eat Feet was laughing at me because there was a soldier over here, and I saw him move, and I just started shooting at him. They'll never survive on their own. Yeah, I do. I shoot at anything that moves, Eat Feet. That's why you don't want me to have a gun in my hand during the zombie apocalypse. I'll probably kill more people than zombies.
Dang. Dang.
Yeah, do not hang out with me during the zombie apocalypse. You like bend down to tie your shoe and I shoot you in the face. Oh my god. Speaking of cheesy comedies, you know, I was looking one up the other day. I haven't seen it in a long time, but I wanted to rewatch it. And I couldn't find anywhere that had it. Netflix didn't have it. I think Microsoft or Xbox Games or Xbox Movies and TV has it. So I might just rent it on there for like $3. But it's called Out Cold. Have you ever seen that, Lil C?
Nope.
No? It's the guy from Mallrats. Oh, there's a gun in here. Grenade launcher. Sweet.
The chopper's back to finish the job. HQ, come in. This is Alpha. The chopper is targeting us now.
I get a grenade launcher too. Chopper down and bring it down
hard. Damn it. Let's I don't need.
Hey, y'all gonna let the man walk right upstairs, soldiers?
Right?
Dang, they can.
Oh.
Wow, I guess that finishes job.
I know, I should be saving those for the helicopter, but Eat Feet remembers that one. So Out Cold is it was Zach Galifianakis, you know, from Hangover. It's one of his first movies. And Jeremy whatever from Mallrats. And they basically are a bunch of people that live in a small mountain town with a small ski resort, and it doesn't really make a ton of money. And it's just kind of like, you know, a little bit more laid back. And Lee Majors comes in and he wants to turn it into a resort place. So they have to like, so it's basically like, you know, the place gets like, oh shit, I just shot a tree. There we go. Damn, that was fast.
Yeah, very.
And he comes in, he fixes up the town, and he fixes up their bar, and he adds a bunch of stuff to it, and he brings his... He's kind of like Donald Trump a little bit. He has, like, a hot Swedish daughter, and he brings her to the town, and everyone... All the guys kind of are trying to have sex with her. And they spruce up the ski resort, and then the people who used to live there, they start not liking it. Because the history of the mountain is being like tramped over by all these people with money. So it's pretty funny though. I'm probably not selling it that well as a comedy, but it is a very funny, funny movie.
I think the last comedy I just seen was it was just in theater. It's called Why Him? I think that's what it's called.
Oh yeah. How was it?
Actually, I kind of liked that movie, Why Him. I think what's that dude's name? Walter White from Breaking Bad was in there. I don't know what his real name is, but I just call him Heisenberg. Or I don't know what his name is, but it was a pretty decent movie. And the dude who played Hobgoblin, I think, was he was in that too.
James Franco, right?
Yep, exactly.
Is it? Do you know if it's a remake? Because when I first saw the trailer, I thought it was a remake of Look Who's Coming Home for Dinner. Do you remember that movie?
I have not. You know what? I haven't really seen too many comedy movies. I wasn't really too far into it. Like when I was growing up, I was like into like cartoons and stuff like that. That's why when you say these comedy movies, I'd be like, what? I only seen a select few of them, though.
Look Who's Coming to Dinner. It's an older movie. I don't even expect most people to know what it is, but it's Sidney Poitier is in it, who a phenomenal actor, and he's dating a white girl, and she brings him to dinner. to meet her parents. Yeah. And she's like, and they're like, what? He's black, you know? And so this is like, I can't remember if it was the 60s or 70s, but so when I saw Why Him, I was like, oh, that looks like the same plot.
It's kind of like the same way, except for it's not white and black. It's actually the white girl and the white guy, but it's kind of like they didn't tell them that. Well, she didn't tell her family that she had a boyfriend when she was in college, and they found out the hard way. And it's a lot of, I'm not gonna give away the movie, but it's a lot of crazy things that go on there. It's a pretty decent movie. I would say give it a try if you could, whenever it comes out.
Oh shit, Invisi Snake.
Oh, that was a snake.
Yeah. Boom. I don't know. If I could turn invisible, I think I'd always be invisible. It's like, why won't this thing show itself? It's built to be invisible, dude. Like,
did they ever explain how this snake turns invisible?
Yeah, it's... Yeah, it basically is... it's like a snake, but like they... With the C virus that they, and after some of the damage it took in the testing phase, like I said, you know, things, your limbs will regrow or tissue will regrow as a different animal. And it kind of regrew in almost like a chameleon type way. So it just camouflages like a chameleon would. It's not like bending light, but it's more like just adapting to the colors around it.
Okay.
But yeah, I thought it's in one of the files. It has a weird Serbian name too. All the monsters have Serbian names. Do you even hear yourself? Eat Feet said he saw Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Not bad. I dislike Harry Potter, so I was surprised, he said. Have you seen that movie?
I haven't. I wanted to see that, and actually he brought up one that I forgot to go see.
Fantastic Beasts. I'll be honest with you. I don't even think I've seen a full Harry Potter movie. I started the first one when it came out on, I think it was like the second movie was out in the theaters, and my mom's like, "Hey, will you watch the first one with me?" And she put it on, and I fell asleep like 20 minutes in. and then the fifth one came out, and my aunt, who she's passed away now, but she was a big Harry Potter fan. She worked at Disney and stuff. Got me my first job at Disney actually too. And she loved those movies. So I went, when I lived out here in California, she came out here for a trip and was like, "Hey, let's go have dinner. Let's catch up. And, you know, let's see if, let's see this Harry Potter movie." And we went and saw it and I fell asleep during it. I was like, what the hell? And then the sixth one, which I think was part one of a two-part finale or something. Or maybe the seventh one.
Yeah, definitely Hollows.
Yeah, same thing. Fell asleep. And I wouldn't even say those movies were boring me. I think it was just bad days to watch them. I think I was just tired all those days. It was coincidence.
That's understandable. I kind of like the Harry Potter collection. It's a pretty good saga, I guess you can call it now.
Yeah. I did read the first book, though. When this new book came out, the one that's like a play or something, when that came out, I bought the first book and I actually read it in like a week. And the book was pretty good, actually. So it makes me want to go watch all the movies now. Oh shit. Confusion said he just ate the best fried catfish. Dude, yum. There's too much rubble in the way. From where? Did you make it at home or did you buy it somewhere? If it's that good, I hope it's homemade. Do you eat seafood at all, Lil C?
Yeah. I kind of limit the seafood like to certain things, but I only eat small amounts of that, like catfish, salmon, tilapia, some shrimp. So.
Okay. Oh, made it home. Yum. Confusion. Yum, dude. Yeah, catfish. I mean, I like, I appreciate good food, but I wouldn't say I eat a lot of seafood. I don't really, I like shrimp too. And I like gumbo and stuff like that. Like I grew up outside of New Orleans. So it's kind of hard not to eat it, but I will say I'm probably even more limited than probably you are with it. Like I'm very, I don't really mess with it too much.
Yeah, and I only kind of eat shrimp like inside of shrimp fried rice, and that's dang it, only Chinese food I eat, so. So, I hear the snake, but I don't see the snake.
How do I, it won't let me drop shit. Wait. Oh, it's because I have it equipped, okay. I'm trying to drop some flash grenades because I don't need them. I want to make sure I have more ammo. All right, I'm coming down. Shit!
What was that?
I jumped downstairs and it came up behind me. Confusion says missing out. If it looks good, eat it. Well, yeah, but but if I don't order it, then I don't know it looks good. If I was at someone's house for dinner and they're like, hey, we made fried catfish homemade, I'd be like, well, okay, shit, I'm going to eat your catfish, obviously. Because it would be rude not to, but yeah, otherwise I'm going to order a steak. LOL, yeah. snake, gator, and frog legs is the best in Nola. Yeah, no kidding. Yeah, frog legs. Oh my god. I wouldn't say I like frog legs, but it, like I said, if someone ordered some and split with the table, I'll have a frog leg or two.
I don't know if I could pull myself to eat frog legs just because of the name of it.
Dude, I've eaten weird shit. I've eaten like bugs. Like, yeah. I'm not saying it's my favorite or anything. I'm just saying if someone's like, you'll really offend me if you don't eat this spider, I'm like, all right, I guess I'm eating that fucking spider.
Oh, man. And you said they eat alligator down there too?
Oh, gator? Yeah, oh, absolutely, man. And snake. Yeah, they eat snake too.
Wow.
Yeah. There's such an abundance of them down there. I think they're just like, well, we got to do something about this gator infestation.
Yeah. I want to go to New Orleans one day.
It's fun, man. It's a good town. It's a lot of history. Actually, there. I love
Now I think about it. You live in the best place where I want to go. You live out there in LA, right? California?
I do. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a little bit of a melting pot out here. There's one thing I miss about New Orleans is the food, for sure. And there's actually a place here in LA in the Grove that makes really authentic Cajun food. From gumbo to beignets. Nice. Yeah, beignets, like frog legs, like they make it all. It's freaking awesome.
Oh, man, that thing, okay. I wasn't expecting to do that.
We're in the middle of it now. Oh, shit, there it is. Our whole team's just going to die here. Get your ass out of here. You killed my men. I'm going to have crawfish boiled tomorrow because all this talk. Oh, damn, eat feet. Oh, yeah, dude, Eat Feet brings up a good point. He says if you go to the, New Orleans, definitely stay in the French Quarter if you can to avoid the touristy spots.
Oh, am I dead?
Shit, are you dead?
Almost. I didn't know what was going on. I thought that was an insta-kill scene.
All right, I'm coming. Oh, that's right. That when you're crawling through here, it comes. Yeah, I remember that. Yeah. Shit, dude.
Okay, I'm being squeezed.
I got you.
What you just saved my life.
Hey, what are friends for?
Yeah, I didn't remember nothing like that was gonna happen.
Checkpoint. We must have heard it. All right, I think we go in here now.
Thing is in here. Time to put an end to this.
Shit. Yeah, when I was moving out here to California, I stopped in New Orleans. Watch out. Sorry.
Okay.
I stopped in New Orleans to see some friends from, because I was living in Orlando. And so I had some friends that got married and then they moved to New Orleans. So I was like, all right, on my way to California, I'll stop by New Orleans. It was my birthday. I was like, I don't want to spend the birthday in my car driving from, you know, one side of the country to the other. So I'll stop, I'll get some good food in New Orleans, hang out with some friends, and it'll be a good time. I was only supposed to stay there for 2 days. I was there for about a week and a half.
You know what I really want to try from New Orleans, though? That good that? Old jambalaya.
Oh, my God. Dude, I will say definitely get authentic jambalaya, but if you ever want, like, a really close version, like I said, out here in L.A., that place I go to, they make some amazing jambalaya.
Ah, Seek, you making me jealous, man. I need to get out to to L.A. right now. Oh, man.
It's funny you say Capcom overuses the big thing too much, and now they have a big invisible thing. I know, right? I always talk about that, like how Capcom just goes way over with their stuff. Their excuse for it is that, oh, it's Umbrella. Like, they, you know, they plan to destroy the world. They don't do anything small, and it's like, okay, that's a good defense. But man, is it funny how often they use it.
One is they gonna have some type of giant insect or creature on number 7.
I was thinking about that. I mean, it wouldn't be very Resident Evil without one, but at the same time, like, it doesn't. It really wouldn't matter to me.
Kind of. I don't know why. I feel like it'll be kind of far fetched how they got the game, though. We'll see, though.
Ooh. Eat Feet says, come visit him down in Texas and you get some Tex-Mex. It's really good.
Yeah, Texas. Man, if I was still over the road driving, I probably could make it down there, but I'm doing local now. I probably have to take a vacation.
Sure.
I remember this part. It's something about some generators because he get ate up. Oh, wait a minute. Okay.
Confucius says, it seems they went to something where something made people go crazy in 7. Yeah, you know, I don't know what the story is, but the Baker family definitely seem off the rockers, right? To the point where they're... No, I got it. Oh, shit. Okay. I was like, no, he crawled over it.
He tried. That's like a big plug-in right there.
Yeah, and he didn't wait for... He should have said, hey, flip the switch, turn it off. All right, so I think one of us has to go down.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, one of us has to go. I'll be the bait. You stay up here and operate the control.
Okay.
Just hit him right when he hits this water here. Fry him up. There he is. Get him. Nice work. Bam. Died right at my feet too. Good, that's a good shot. We fried that son of a bitch. Yeah, I'm curious. The Bakers seem like out of their freaking gorge, but at the same time, like, what makes me scary is like, or what makes it scary is, are they victims or are they like just like the Texas Chainsaw Massacre family, where they're just like, hey, we just like eating people, and then, oh yeah, by the way, we're also mutated monsters. It's like, oh shit.
Whatever happened to the other Bakers? I know it's the dad or the mom, and then it's another one. Oh.
Yeah, there's...
It's like a guy, yeah.
Yeah, Lucas, he's the son. They mention him in the demo. There's a... They say, like, Lucas was, like, a bad seed. Like, I guess he was a bad kid or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's so I guess he'll play. I guess he plays some part, but they haven't showed much of him. So a lot of people are speculating about what he might be, and a lot of people are speculating about the grandma, and a lot of cool stuff happening. I'm excited because it just looks different. Like, I love Resident Evil; it's great to me, but it's I think it's just time for something new. And I remember thinking that when Resident Evil 4 came out, I was like, man, you know what I want? I want something really just new, something different, something I can't predict. And I thought 4 did a good job with that, with Leon fighting not Umbrella and then fighting not even zombies. He was, and then it was like an invasion of the body snatchers kind of thing, where it was like a parasite taking over you. I was like, that's freaking cool. Like, that's different.
Yeah, they changed that one all the way around, because we was used to how Resident Evil 1 was with that weird aiming. Then they brought the red dot and it hit certain body parts. They do certain things. That was cool back then.
Sure. Oh, shit. Dang. Yep. Well, that's the thing, Confusion. That's a good point. Yeah, we don't know. They could be normal being driven crazy, or they could be the ones who are driving others crazy. It's totally, totally true. Eat Feast says, I hope Capcom doesn't leave holes in the plot to push the DLC aspect. I'd lose my fucking shit if that's the case. Yeah, I hate when any company does that. So I'm with you. Oh, there he is. Shoot it.
Oh, I have no bullets. You know shit, what? I completely forgot about that, too. Wow. Oof. I see you remember though, see.
Yeah.
The little bug inside of it.
The only reason I knew that was coming was because of the research I did. I haven't played the Chris campaign in full in a while. So probably a year. But yeah, I'm with you on that one, Eat Feet. I mean, DLC, it's a tricky thing. DLC is a very fine line you got to walk with DLC, because good DLC, the reason DLC exists is one of the many main reasons, is because when a company spends three, four years making a game, the thing they worry about the most is, oh, people will play it, and then 2 weeks later, they beat everything of it, and then they never talk about our game again. And that's a long time to put something into. Like, movies get the theatrical release, they get the Blu-ray release, they can later make a special edition of it. Like, movies can live for years because of the different versions and extended stuff. Games don't get that. So DLC, if you're using it to keep the game around and keep people playing it who stop after 2 weeks and let them come back, if you're doing DLC for that reasons, cool. That's what DLC is for. But yeah, if you purposely leave stuff out of the game so the DLC will explain it, that's not cool. I'm definitely not into that.
Ooh, don't be like, what's that game called? Dead or Alive, the DLCs is nothing but costumes. That stuff is so silly.
Pretty much, yeah. As long as that they had nothing to do with it, it won't be too bad. But I had day one DLC. That's true. Well, the first DLC that's coming out for Resident Evil 7 is free. They announced that the other day. It's not part of the season pass. It's just something that I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's to clear up the story. I don't know. But it was clearly something that was in development while they were making the game, because it's coming out really quick. So,
wow, they're giving us something for free?
Yeah, oh yeah, you get a free DLC called, all I know about it is called Hero, something Hero, like Not a Hero or something like that, and it's free. Jamali, hello and welcome. Everybody, send some love to Jamali, who we haven't seen in a while. Jamali, how you feeling? How's your mom feeling? Let the chat know. And let Lil C and I know how you're doing.
What up, Jamali?
by the way, Jamali, she bought her wedding dress today. How awesome. How freaking, yeah, Jamali's getting married. That is freaking awesome, Jamali.
You know what? I'll take a second to say congratulations.
Amen. Congrats.
That is very good.
And her future, or current boyfriend, future fiance, current fiance, future husband, he's awesome. He's a really awesome dude.
Good. I like to hear happiness, because there's so much bad things going on in the world. That's very good.
No shit. Yeah.
You want to follow me around? Fine. Make sure you stay out of my way.
Jesus, Chris, can you like be like 3% less a dick? Like, come on. I'm not stupid enough to fall for her bullshit. I think we got to run. This is a running level.
I'm going to try to keep up with you. I'm still getting used to this still. Wait a minute. Why? Oh, okay. I got to wait till you do yours.
Oh. You hit me, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's all right. I probably deserved it.
Oh, that's blocked.
Oh, so we're not running yet. Okay, gotcha. All right.
Oops.
Boom, you dead. Bam, you dead too.
There's some crates back here. Well, some ammo probably.
Nice, thank you.
Yep. This look like a good place for them to put some emblems at. But I don't
know,
see
right?
any.
Here's another crate. Two crates. Mom is home and good, and I've been a little sick, but okay now. Oh, awesome. That's good to hear. Speaking of hate, did y'all see Martin Shkreli got hit by poop last week? No, I didn't. That's fucked. Really? Oh, my God. Hit by poop. Who throws poop anymore? It's amazing. Oh my God, that's funny. Throwing poop. Oh my God, what? Yeah, I know, right, Drumley? Some protester just straight up nailed him with poop. That was the best thing ever. Yeah, that is a weird messenger from God right there. All right. So I guess we don't run yet. Okay, fair enough. Oh shit, what's up, bro?
Whoa, it's a lot of snipers on us. Let's see.
Oh shit, he's getting chicken legs.
Ah, you took him down.
Yeah, he's gone. Boom. Oh, shit. Ow.
Oh, no, yeah, one please. Is growing. Where?
Take the time to reload, Seek. Why not? Oh, shit. You got a big guy over there?
Yeah, I'm finna try to take care of him.
I got your back. Here we go. Oh, shit. I was like protecting you. There's one right behind me.
Oh, you ahead of me. I thought you was behind me. Okay.
We missed you too, Jom. Definitely. I was asking about you the other night. We were playing two nights ago, and then last night I was looking for you too. But I figured you were resting and stuff, and I hope I'm glad your mom's doing well and that she's home. More good news from Jomley. You're really making 2017 rock, Jomley. Starting this year off good. Oh, shit. Oh, that was you again.
Yeah.
I got to learn to get out of the way.
No, it's like if you jump and they on the boat, it kind of shakes it and make them do that.
Ah, gotcha.
The animation okay. Right there.
Oh, look at that. That's right, Jomley. The year of dreams. Oh shit, Simmons! Here we go. Run! Oh shit. Yep, this is where we become Mission Impossible or Jack Reacher or
some along those lines.
Yeah. Mission Impossible 5. There we go. Got him. Snap. Keep moving. Run. So what you drinking, Jom? Oh, shit. Eat feet on the fucking drop on that one. Nice. Got him. Got him. You mugging me? That's awesome.
If we can just get to that building.
Yep, I'm trying. Shit! Oh, I'm dead. Damn, dude. Damn, I was like right behind you too.
Oh, he exploded the boat.
Oh. Yeah, he exploded the boat with me on it. I was, and it was weird. I was like right behind you. I stopped to take one shot at a guy because I just, there was no way I could run around him.
Yeah.
And that was enough to get me killed. Damn it. So death count, if anyone's able, I think John Lee is able to do death count. Damn it,
it's
yo,
like
I'm
we
up
colliding
in this
into each other.
I know, John Lee, you distracted me. I was like, ooh, John Lee's here, and I got all nervous, and I died. Thank you, John Lee. Actually, can you add one more? Can you do that? Give it a minute. I think you have to wait a minute, but in a minute, do it one more time, because we had one death earlier. Oh, good, we made it. Oh, shit. I made it, yes! Woo! All right, time to play the gong. Zeke has died 221 times during zombie month. Luckily, he is still human for now. Alright. This fucking chopper. Where you going, bitch?
Watch out behind you.
I see him. Ow.
And that thing. Some type of spider behind us? Oh, okay.
There's something. But I was just focused on that freaking chopper. I'm like, I'm taking it down. I don't give a shit.
Oh, no, you did. Dang, did you get blown up?
Kinda.
Look.
I don't like to talk about it. That fool brought a machete to a grenade launcher fight. Smack my head. Yeah. He did. Now we get Ada. Copy that. All right, just keep running. She's here. There we go.
Hey, behind you.
Shit. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Behind you.
Uh-oh, now we in a whole fight.
Yeah.
This dude did a whole karate stance.
All right, we did it. Look out! It's always fun getting those, like, 30-second delay, like, dude, watch your back. It's like, oh. It's like I'm either already dead or I got hit anyway. I love that.
Hold your fire. Hold your fire.
How are you doing the commands?
You got a whole B and then directionals, and the thank you is like R, B, or L, B. What would be?
Okay, that's awesome. Give me a minute. Yeah, they really wanted this thing to be like some kind of Call of Duties type game.
You respond with B too. Like they get a headshot, you just press B, like your partner.
Ah, gotcha. So yeah, this place here is funny. You actually have to play it in their campaign and pay attention to that sign they were leaning against outside to even know it's a medical facility. Because I was like, oh, it's just an abandoned warehouse. It's like, nope, it's actually a medical facility.
Dang, he went straight for the fire.
Yeah, he was. He did not give a shit. You can't run forever. Pills here. Eat feet. Oh, good old Left 4 Dead. No use
hiding, Ada. Just like a blanket. That game. Is that a Left 4 Dead compatible too? Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Absolutely. It is 1 and 2.
Oh wow! I used to play that all day.
You should join us. We played two. I think two is the only one. Well, no, actually, it's this weird thing that we had to learn. Like Deadeye taught us. We were playing. You have to log out of your Xbox One account and log into your Xbox 360 account. Oops, that was a little overkill. You did it. All right, we made it. Sweet. Peels. We're going to be giving away a bottle of Peels on Monday on my channel with this awesome Left 4 Dead 2 backpack that has a bottle of Peels in it.
What type of Peels are those?
It looks like an ibuprofen bottle, but there's nothing in it.
Oh, okay.
When I bought it, I think it had candy in it. But yeah, there's otherwise nothing really in it. Oh, treasure. All right, here we go. Do you want to hack or do you want to shoot the things on the ground?
I was never no good at the hacking part because it. Who knows what this bitch has in store? Dang.
Yeah. Chris, you're a bag of dicks.
Chris mean on here.
It had candy? Yeah, eat feet. Well, I it's like I got it like a year ago, so if it's still candy,
Try to say you ate the candy.
Yeah, I wasn't going to give away the old candy. Nah, I think the candy, it was full of Mike and Ikes. We were walking around Comic-Con. We were walking around Comic-Con eating the Mike and Ikes. Your little bag of tricks isn't going to stop us. See if you can hold those things off, Captain. I'll get us past the lock. Security breach detected in room 1. Oh shit. Oh god, that backpack is amazing. Aw, yeah, it's pretty cool. Oh shit, ow. Yeah, that thing's pretty cool, for sure. Stupid QTEs.
You might get hit. Oh!
Shit. That's right. If I get hit, it's cool. Damn it. There's like a rhythm to these, and I'm. Bam. Got it. One more. Bam. Got it. I think. Yep, I got it. Cool. All right, phone, chill out. I do like that backpack though. It's pretty cool. It doesn't hold much, but it works. It holds pills. Oh, hey, thanks. I was like, yeah, I'm getting sprayed right now. Do we go that way or do we go that way?
Oh, no, I was trying something off of Batman when you could slide through the vent. It don't work on here, though.
Which is funny because actually the guy who does the voice of Chris, I think in this game in 5, is the guy who did Batman's voice, I think, in Batman Origins, Arkham Origins.
Really?
Yeah. Because I remember playing Arkham Origins and be like, oh, that's the dude who plays Chris Redfield. And then I was like, oh, shit, that dude's like, they're both big. Like, Chris Redfield's as big as Batman.
Mm-hmm. And I ain't played Arkham Origins in a minute.
Oh my god, it's backwards compatible now, and I saw it at GameStop yesterday for $8, and I thought about getting it because I actually kind of like that game.
Yeah, it was a good game. I liked it, that one.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't. The only thing I didn't like about it is that they basically recycled the map from Arkham City, so they didn't really add anything level wise. But still, I thought it had a good storyline to it. Kitty Money, what is up? My previous Resident Evil 6 partner in crime, who played Helena Harper. Welcome, me and Lil C are Chris Redfield and Piers Nivens today.
That's his last name, Nivens.
Nivens, yep.
Okay.
Can't believe Leon can't tell that he sees like an Ada wearing a red dress, and then he sees an Ada in a blue dress, and he doesn't think there's... He thinks she made time to change clothes during the zombie apocalypse. John Lee says, I don't need much in the backpack, so it's okay that the backpack is small. Oh, yeah, everyone send Kitty some love. A thousand. He did command emerge. Phew, and I'm back. Welcome back, 1K. Yeah? Guys, there can be more than one bad guy.
You're still going to protect this woman?
I am. See, this scene here, why I don't like it, is the Ada behind Leon should be the real Ada. Like, if you're going to have this emotional scene, Ada needs to see Leon sacrifice everything he believes in for her, you know? Having it be the fake Ada is just a bunch of bullshit. Kitty says Perry's nipples? No, his name is Pierce Nivens.
Wow.
One K wants to know what he missed. You want to give him a little brief summary of the last chapter?
What happened?
Yeah, and you can do it as comically as you want.
I don't remember. That's all I can remember. All I remember is this dude meeting Leon and a lot of some clone stuff and monsters popping out and running.
Eat Feet says you missed the twerk off.
What? The twerk off?
Yeah. We were twerking for feels, John Lee says.
Wow.
Yep.
It's a machine gun part on him? No, this... stop until I do.
All right.
They might have the worst person behind the gun ever.
They may have the worst person behind the wheel ever.
Oh, man, we both got a hard job, Dan.
Yeah. No one said I could drive. Still waiting on that Xbox request, Lil C, Kitty says.
I thought I added it. I must didn't.
I do that all the time. So I'm like, I didn't send you a request. They're like, no. I'm like, oh, okay. I'm like, shit, I thought I did.
Dude, the aiming is so funny. I can't even lie to you right now.
Well, I just learned how to drive like 10 seconds after it started. I'm like, the only reason we were going forward is because I hit the boost button. I'm like, wait, oh, that's not the acceleration button? Oh, shit. They're like so far ahead of us.
Man, there's one vehicle on the road.
Yeah, here we go.
Step on it, we're losing her. Chris to HQ, lock up all the exits.
Sorry, no can do. All of our units are currently engaged. I don't have any to spare.
Damn it! Do you think this is part of our plans?
This is like the most awkward part they could have put in a game, a chase scene in a car.
Yeah, it's so weird. I can't believe we actually made it to the checkpoint. I thought,
dude,
I thought we were
going
to get a game over.
Dude, I was just going to say that. I thought that we was going to get the game over screen myself. Yeah. All
right, here we go. We're good. We're caught up to her now. Shoot,
we're supposed
shooter,
to be shooting
shooter.
At her car.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, my aim is about to be absolutely horrible.
There'll be other things to shoot at, but for now, we just aim at her car. There we go. There's a bad guy. There we go. I'll try to ram him off the road if I can. Boom. Move. Get out the way. Get out
the
way.
Yeah, you over here gone.
Oh, see ya. Well, now that's a lot of pressure on me, Pierce. All right. Get her. Oh, shit. That was a bad time to use the acceleration on three curves. All right. Yeah, this is such a weird level. It's like, oh, all of a sudden we're going to be, like, in a car, high-speed car chase.
Yeah, I don't remember this, and this is very bad. Resident Evil didn't have no car chases. What is this?
Yeah, and Sherry Birkin, I think, in hers, she's on a motorcycle with Jake right now, like, riding through, yeah. And that's another chase level, yeah. Hashtag catch up. I know, I'm trying. Checkpoint. As long as we keep making the checkpoints, that's it. Sega's a better driver than me and the the CPU is a fucking bad driver on this game.
Wow. Wait a minute. The computer can actually drive on here? Dang.
Yeah, because when you play one player, yeah, you're kind of forced to be Chris, and the game is Pierce. Oof. All right. So far, so good. Here we go. Who left the sports car with the keys conveniently left and it parked out? Oh, shit. I was reading the chat. I thought we were dead.
I seen us go straight for the corner of the wall, too.
I thought we were fine. I was like, oh, shit, we're dead. We are fucking dead. Who left the sports car with keys? Yeah, that's right. Totally did. Shit, that was funny. I looked away from the chat and I just see this corner come. I'm like, no! All right, now you guys get to see my driving skills and how bad they are. Oh, shit. Oh, why is my reticle going so fast?
Yeah, that's what I've been going through. It's like super fast, too.
It's so, yeah, I can't, like, damn, this is tough. Oh, there's an emblem. See it?
Oh, yeah.
Shoot it before we get the last guy. Tell me when you got it.
I should have hit it, like, 12 times with this reticle.
Aim higher. You're still a little low.
I see it going straight through there. No. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Got it.
All right. Sweet. That was a little tense. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, we was inching ever closer to death right there.
All right, here we go.
Grab your gun. I'm taking the wheel.
Oh,
oh
shit.
No. How do you drive now?
The right trigger is accelerate. Left trigger is brake if you need it for sharp turns. And the A button is your boost.
Oh, this ought to be interesting. She's not getting away
again. Does the gun overheat?
I don't think so. Dude. I'm gonna have to commend you for them driving skills, because this is horrible.
I'm gonna have to commend you for your shooting skills, because this thing is moving so fast. Out. Hit that boost if you got it. There you go. Nice. Oh my god, I'm so dizzy right now. I'm sorry, people in the chat. Alright. Boost. Nice. Oh shit.
Too much boost.
That's alright, dude. That's good. As long as we get those checkpoints, we're good. Nice. Oh.
Oh, oh shit. No.
Oh, shit.
Dang. I touched a piece of the corner. We're dead. Here we go. Oh, I got to start over. She's not getting away again. Where is the energy line for this truck?
It's right there, the green bar.
Oh, okay. Oh, it was already real when I got up in here. Okay.
Yeah. I think it was.
It carried over.
It carried over. That was my fault that we died, because that was all the damage I took. All right, hit that boost. Yeah, when we were trying to aim at that emblem, we took a rocket launcher shot, I think, to us.
That might have
hit us. Yeah, pretty good. Yeah. Luckily, he missed with the second two shots, but that first one hit us pretty good. Oh shit. Death count? Oh yeah, I don't know if John Lee's still here, but yeah, we could use one, actually two more death counts. Because we still didn't get that one from earlier. Oh, nice boost, nice, dude. Oh shit,
Dang, are we flying? Okay.
Yeah, I think the boost on that downward spiral, we were like, we kept leaving the ground. Oh shit.
Wow, they came back? That's crazy.
Oh, whoa.
I did not want to hit none of that.
It's okay. We're almost there. We did it. Nice work.
Wait, man, you trying to tell me they bridged that long jump right there?
Yeah, with no ramp and in a fucking Humvee.
That was pretty absurd right there. I don't know how that happened.
Gotcha. John Lee did add it. I'm sorry. Thank you, Kitty. And thank you, everyone who was paying attention. Sweet, man. End of chapter 3, dude.
This open window can lead somewhere or nowhere. It's up to you. What do you mean, who is this? It's Chris. Why won't you believe me?